Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Urmila Pol. I am from Department of Computer Science, Shivaji University, Kolhapur, which is the leading university in rural Maharashtra. Today, the topic of my discussion is installation of Moodle on Ubuntu 16.4. Some brief information about my university and development of Moodle report plugin, template of that. We have included Moodle icon for easy use of Moodle to every faculty member of university. Shivaji University established in 1962. Its jurisdiction over three districts, Kolhapur, Sangli, Satara. 283 affiliated colleges are there. University 40 departments are there. Recognized research institutes, 13 institutes are there. Over 4 lakhs students are there. And distance education also, more than 50,000 students are there. Use of ICT in university, we have already implemented online secured remote paper delivery system is in exam. Online entrance examinations for MPhil, PhD, MSc, B computer science semester examinations are in practice. They are all online examinations. Online declaration of results, delivery of statement of marks, and application for evaluation, convocation is also practiced. All the examination account section is automized in university. Results are declared in proper time. Moodle helps us in bridging the gap between various academic activities like look at the slide. This is our Moodle server, which is administered by network administrator of university, and various streams. We have implemented this Moodle. More than 650 courses are created in Moodle in science, engineering and technology, social sciences, commerce and management, arts and fine arts, law, education, distance education, various streams we have used that. Spread of Moodle over campus, more than 650 courses are there. Now technical, this is the next session, which is very much technical. I assume that every participant have Linux knowledge of Linux operating system. First, we have to Moodle installation on Ubuntu 16.4 means Moodle Ubuntu server is there. Ubuntu machine is available. It is already installed 16.4. Then we go for Moodle installation. First, we have to update the machine. After installation of any operating system, latest packages are not available. Therefore, we can update the machine. Then it will take all the latest packages on the machine. Therefore, we can install various softwares which are required for the further process. Then install Apache server, which is required to execute our Moodle site, web server. Now, MySQL database is required because all the Moodle data is stored on the database. PHP is the language. Next, install additional softwares. Then after installation of that software, we restart web server to take appropriate changes. Git is a version control system which keep track of all the versions of Moodle. Then using Git, we have to clone the Moodle software using Git. And after installation of Moodle software, it will default store into web root. Here Moodle 16.04 web root is /www/var/var/html/moodle. It is the default folder after installation of Moodle. Web root, you cannot upgrade the latest copy of Moodle. Therefore, you can copy that Moodle folder from /opt to web root and give the permissions for the access. Then set up MySQL server. MySQL server which is stored, MySQL configuration file is stored into /etc/etc folder of Linux operating system. We stored all system files. Therefore, we have to search for MySQL conf file and update that file and add three lines. Default storage engine is equal to InnoDB, and InnoDB file per table is equal to 1. InnoDB file format is equal to Barracuda. These three lines we have to insert at the end of that file. Then restart MySQL server. Then it will take the changes. It will changes to take effect. Then start MySQL. Non-root user is required to install this sudo service MySQL restart. This is the command to restart the MySQL server, which takes appropriate changes after installation. Then this is the time to set up, open the MySQL command line interface. How to open that? Using dollar prompt MySQL minus u root minus p. Means MySQL is the user, root is the user, and it is ready to take the password from user. Minus p, then enter MySQL password. Then create, whenever Moodle is installed, then Moodle data is generated, and database is essential to store the information. Therefore, Moodle user is required. Create database Moodle. First, you have to create the database, and then create Moodle user. These are the MySQL commands which are used to create database Moodle. Default character set. This is the command to create database. Then create user, Moodle user, at localhost identified by, you have to give the Moodle username and Moodle password. Here, username is Moodle user, and Moodle pass is the password. You can create any number of users using this command in MySQL. Then you have to give the permissions for the newly created user. Grant, select, insert. All the data manipulation permissions are there. If you don't give the permission, you cannot create any transactions using that user. Therefore, grant, select, insert, update, delete, create, temporary tables, all these permissions you can give to Moodle user at localhost identified by Moodle pass. Then complete setup. First, you have to give the permissions for web root, that is 777, means read, write, execute access for user, group, and owner. And you, after installation of that, you have to revert the permission of Moodle folder. Then you have to change the permissions. After that, edit config.php file for Moodle. If you want to, after completion of installation, it will take http:// IP address of server. Your server have some IP address, dynamic or static. Take that server address / Moodle. If you don't require Moodle, then you can change the config.php file. This is the server created by me in Ubuntu 16.4. After that, I want to tell you about how to develop a report plugin using Moodle. This presentation will give you an idea about developing a plugin in Moodle. The plugin development will be explained with a sample plugin, which is a display last user, a list of user who access the course in some specific time, date range and time. Every participant have Moodle and PHP, knowledge of Moodle and PHP and plugin. Various list of Moodle plugins are available. When you want to develop any plugin, then first you select the type of plugin, which type of plugin you want to develop. Here, I want to develop a report plugin, therefore I select report. Then Moodle report plugin documentation is available, and coding styles are also provided by Moodle. It is mandatory to follow the coding styles, because it is an important part of any project development in Moodle. Various code checker useful tools are available, code checker and Moodle PHP doc checker. These are the available tools. Next, when you want to develop any plugin, these are the following steps. which are very much required, adding database tables, defining capabilities, declaring the language settings, version control, defining the settings, and plugin-based code. Actual logic is required. Then folder structure for report plugin. I want to create a report plugin. Then I want to go for WebRoot. WebRoot for Ubuntu 16.4 is where www.html/moodle/report. It is already existing folder in Moodle after successful completion of installation of Moodle. Then you create your folder, that is your plugin name, under report directory. Suppose here my plugin name is urplxs. I want to make dir urplxs under report plugin, report folder, report urplxs. Look at the screen. Report urplxs under WebRoot. WebRoot means WebRoot folder. As per the operating system, it is different. Then, using XML editor, you can create your database tables. How to go for that? In Moodle, site administration development, XML DB editor is there. Using that, you can create your tables, which are required for plugin. Here, database tables are not required. We can see the process. First, when you generate your folder, that is a writable access is required for DB folder and files. When you go for XML DB editor, after pressing that, all the database locations of plugins are available on the Moodle web page. Then search for your plugin. What is the plugin name? urplxs. urplxs/db. It is available on Moodle screen. Then search for that. Here, when you search for that, it is available after creating folder. Then create link is enabled. After pressing create link, load link is enabled. After pressing load, it will enable, edit is enabled, edit XML and doc. All the links are enabled. After pressing edit link, it will create XML file. It will automatically generated after pressing create. Here, database tables are not required, but default ID, one field table is generated automatically. Then after that, edit XML file is generated. If you want to change that, you change. Here, at the end of screen, new table, new field, some links are there. Using that, you can create your database tables. After that, it will all the information or the database details are stored in XML file. When you want to use that database tables, then it loads from XML file. After all these things, the plugin is ready. It is when you open your Moodle IP address with Moodle, then it will show notifications. It is ready to install. After installing, it shows success. This is the common format for install.php file, which is generated after XML.db editor. And after that, we want to generate access.php file. How many folders are required here? First, when you go for WebRoot, then first folder is DB. Under DB, install.xml, it is generated automatically, and another file is there, access.php. Access.php contains the page access control parameters, which contain capabilities, dollar capabilities. It is the array of report/urplxs:view. It is the capability, and our naming convention is report. Report is the plugin type. urplxs is the plugin name, colon capability. View is the capability. Then another parameter, risk bitmask. Risk bitmask is used for personal various risks are available with the capability. Risk of personal, XOR, various etc. Then another parameter, capability type, read or write. For viewing, For viewing, you can give read access and for page read. And writing, cap type is equal to write. Then contest level, which contest you want to use that plugin, then context level is equal to is context course. Archetypes means archetypes, which role want to use this page or this plugin. Then use manager, manager capability allow, means only manager can use that plugin. Then next, in the settings.php and version.php files are also required, and language strings files are also required. Here, we have to setting the values for language strings which are used in our programs. Settings, it is required to open our plugin page, give the path using admin role, and it had add function which have parameter, type of plugin, and the another function is there, new admin external page, which can have capability and another parameter plugin name and path of the plugin. And settings are is equal to null, means no settings for page. Then version.php contain plugin version and plugin required version, current version, required version, and component name of the plugin, plugin type, plugin name. As all these files are generated, then we want to create our user interface using index.php. Using form API, page API, we can generate index.php and index.form.php. Index.php, first folder structure is that I have already told DB language. DB contains two files, access.php, install.php. Then language file is there. Language, in language, you create one folder that is English. Moodle, default language, English language is for Moodle. Then language EN folder is there. In EN folder, you have to generate string file, which is used in your program. Then four files are required, version.php, settings.php, and index.php and index.form.php. Index form is required to design our screen as per our requirement. This is the screen. After plugin execution, display report, course, you have to choose the course. It will display all the courses are generated in Moodle. Select from one course from that. Then after selection of date from two, and after pressing display button, it will display list of user who accessed the course last time. For that, you generate indexform.php, which how many add elements required here? Three fields are there, course, from, and to, date range. Therefore, here, first you have to include config.php file, which require for page design. Then give the name of indexform.php file. Indexform.php file contains our add elements. And here, check the basic permissions and set up page objects. Dollar page object is there. Dollar page API is there to set the page, page settings. Then get the courses. How to display that courses? When you select choose, it will display all the courses are generated on Moodle. You write one query, $SQL is equal to, select ID full name from course. Course is the default table, which is already existing in Moodle. Using MySQL, you can see all the tables of Moodle. Then one of the course table is there. Here we have not generated our tables, but already existing table is there, course. From that, we retrieve the data. And from that retrieving, $DB means you have to use global database from the Moodle. $DB object is there. Then load up the form using $M form. $M form means Moodle form. You can extend Moodle form in indexform.php. After extension of that, you can include that form into index.php. And then $output is the object which is used to display output on the page. Here, after index form.php, we can add our add elements as per the screen. Choose from two, so three fields are required. Then we can design add elements options, $m form add element, select course, get string course, dollar options, align is equal to center. It is a design for our screen. Like that, you have to include your fields. And then load up the, get the data, process the data, and display the report. M form display, it will display the output. We have already existing the database is there, Moodle database. From that, we can access all these data and then display the report. After that, it will display report, a pressing button, advanced Java, username, and date range, last access report. And then it is, I have started learning plugin development. Whatever I learned, I discussed today. I am not an expert for development of plugin, but these are the things I learned some previous days. And this is my journey from started from Melbourne, Australia, then Delhi, and today at Bombay. Thank you. If you have any questions, please ask. Any questions?
I think we do questions in the dev group.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.